On paper, collaborative processor performance control, or CPPC for short, is a UEFI default setting that reveals the performance level of all CPU cores to the OS scheduler, so it can make effective and efficient decisions based on workload. If you wanna know them as well, be sure to check out the video I have now linked above. For example, these are my best performing cores. Anyway, does this feature really work as intended? To find out, I resolved to test all three different combinations of CPPC in Unigine Superposition. Both CPPC on, both CPPC off, and CPPC on, but prefer the cores off. 10 repetitions each. To assess whether their average scores were significantly different from each other, I used an inferential statistical analysis named Repeated Measures ANOVA, executed via software called RStudio. But first, let's take a look at some rather interesting initial data. This graph shows the average max frequency for every physical core. While for cores boost beyond 4350 MHz with the first combo, with the other two, only two cores do so. And just slightly. This graph shows the average max usage for every logical core. With the first combo, only 4 cores are used for more than 30%. With the second one, 6 cores are used. With the third, 8 cores. These observations indeed reflect the intervention of CPPC. With this feature enabled, the OS prefers to use core 4 and 5 of CCX1 at a higher frequency. With it completely or partially disabled, the OS has no preference and simply uses the first 4 cores, namely all of those of CCX0, but at a lower frequency. Incidentally, my first 2 cores are also the second and fourth best ones by hardware rank. So that's good. Now for the last piece of information, a self-explanatory graph. It seems that CPPC off-off and on-off both improve the max frame rate by about 10 FPS, while 2 FPS are respectively lost and gained in the minimum. A side note, CPU voltage, temperature and power consumption are virtually the same across all samples. Finally, the analysis of variance. Since its 4 assumptions are all met, let's move on to the descriptive statistics of my 3 samples. Here is a boring table for the sake of completeness, and here are the box and whisker plots, so that you can visualize the scores better. Sample 2 is characterized by a higher mean, but a broader range and interquartile range than sample 1. On the other hand, sample 3 is characterized by an even higher mean and almost identical ranges. Before running the ANOVA, a quick reminder. If its resulting p-value is greater than 0.01, the 3 means are not significantly different from each other. So the null hypothesis is true. If p-value is less than or equal to 0.01, the 3 means are significantly different from each other. So the alternative hypothesis is true. Since RStudio returns a p-value sample of 0.157, H0 is accepted. The difference between these averages is not statistically significant. Another side note. Since p-value test number is also greater than 0.01, the difference between benchmark runs is not statistically significant. And this is obviously great. In simpler terms, the superposition average score with CPPC on-off isn't significantly higher than the average score with CPPC off-off and on-on. And the same can be said about CPPC off-off and on-on. Basically, in superposition, and I emphasize in superposition, any CPPC combination has no substantial effect on the final score. Nevertheless, these preliminary results are quite promising. Should I repeat this test in a real game and/or with a different power plan boost mode? Let me know in the comment section. Farewell for now,